cycloid, from roller diameter, 40 mm. First, you draw a circle of diameter 40 mm. Draw circle of diameter 40 mm. Concept of cycloid is the roller is moving on a plane surface. Path of a point on the circumference of the moving roller on a straight line gives a cycloid. The locus of path of a moving point on a roller moving on a plane surface without slipping can give cycloid. Construction of cycloid starts like this. First, draw the circle of required radius. Divide the circle into 8 equal parts. Name them as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now, find out the circumference of the circle, that is pi d. Take pi d and draw a line of length pi d. Connect this 1 and 7, draw another line which is parallel to the given line pi d. So, move this 2 and 6 to the same length. So, even you can have a vertical reference line at the end pi d. Join this 3 and 5, let them be on a straight line, connect them to the length pi d. Similarly, draw the line through 4 to a length pi d. So, this length is pi d. D is 40, so pi d comes around 125.6. You can roughly write it as 126. Now divide this 126 into 8 equal parts. First you divide this into 2 equal parts, roughly you get this, then divide this into further 2 parts. Similarly, you have 2 parts. Again, each 2 can be divided into 2 parts. Totally, you get exactly 8 equal parts. Take any suitable construction method to divide the given line into 8 equal parts. Now, take the center line and mark these points on the specific line as C1, C2, C3, C4, C5, C6, C7, last line is C8. See, the roller is rolling on this plane surface. So first position is this, the second position takes the center C1, that position takes the center C2, and so on. The final position is C8. Now get the points for this cycloid. The first point is the starting point in this. Find the first point. For that, take the fixed radius of the roller. Roller radius is fixed. So take the fixed roller radius. By keeping C1 as center and taking the fixed roller radius, you can make an arc on the line 1. this is the fixed polar radius. This will intersect at the point on the line passing through 1. So the first point P1 is obtained. Similarly, with C2 as center, take the same fixed radius, try the arc on the line 2, the line corresponding to 2. So you get one arc. So this point of time is P2. The next, move on to C3, keeping C3 as center, with the radius as same fixed radius of the roller. Put the radial arc on the line connected with 3. So we get this, the point obtained is P3. The obvious point is P4. That is, you take C4 as the center, fix the fixed radius, you will exactly get the point at the top line. This is P4. Similarly, you go to the last point, you will take C8 as center and the fixed radius as radius, it will touch exactly at the bottom. So therefore, this P8 is also an obvious point. You should be very careful. Now you take C5 as center and the fixed radius from the roller radius, cut the arc on the 5 line. That is, this arc can be cut on the 5 line, then you will get P5. Ensure the distance from the center line from left side and the right side should be equal. Then only you can get correct P3 and P5. Because the answer of time is a symmetrical curve. So, ensure the distance from this center point towards P3 and the other side towards P5 should be equal. Go to C6, take C6 as center, with a fixed radius as radius, mark the arc on the line corresponding to 6. So, you will get this arc, you will get the point P6. So, what you can ensure from C4? The distance at P6 and C4 to P2 should be equal. Then keeping C7 as the radius, C7 as the center, sorry, with the radius, that is fixed roller radius, you can make an arc on the line connected with 7, you will be getting one point, that is P7. Now, connect these points with a smooth symmetrical curve. So the answer of time is a cycloid of roller radius 40 mm. Let this dark curve alone be made visible. All the other points and the construction are just guidelines. Ensure your answer is visible. This is only for one revolution. Sometimes the roller may take 2 revolution, 3 revolution and so on. Now the next job is take any point on the given curve. On the curve that is constructed, consider the point as P. If the location of P is given, you have to take that location. Otherwise, just arbitrarily put some point P, take the same roller radius with P as center, cut the arc on the center line, that is the line lies on the line passing through C1, C2, C3, C4, C5, you will be getting one arc. So just draw one perpendicular line, it touches the bottom baseline. Connect the point on this baseline and the given point. The line gives you the normal. Draw 90 degree line for this normal. You will definitely get the tangent. Tangent is marked as mm dash, normal is marked as n dash.